Honestly, it's always only about winning the race. I think with the exception of that run course record, when I first came to Kona, I sort of felt that that could be mine, and I felt that that's the level I should be able to run at. So the first few years, I really kind of got out to the run and knew what the record was, and I sort of was aware of it. So I kind of went after it, the run course record. But last year, honestly, the course record was couldn't have been further from my mind. I really only knew probably 5K from the finish that it was within reach. So honestly, conditions play so much into this race, whether the swell's up, or the wind's on the bike and the heat on the run. So if the island gods give us a nice day, then obviously if records are within reach and we're having a great day, then we go for them. But other than that, we're just trying to execute a great race and get to the finish line as quickly as possible. Yeah, it's kind of funny. Every other year I've sort of come in as a dark horse or an outside, and I sort of took a little bit of offense to that some of the time, because I always felt that I had my best races here, and certainly last year and the year before, being called sort of maybe not a favorite, I sort of was made me a little annoyed, and that kind of helped fuel me. So this year, they've given me the favourite status, but in my mind there's probably 5 girls that can win this race on any given day. So at the end of the day, I still have to go out there, and it's going to be a really tough battle all the way to the end, and I need to be prepared for that. And if I can come up for that, and if I can get my body to cooperate and execute a performance worthy of a world title, then I'll be super happy. I think I can make improvements in swim, bike and run. You know, my coach and I sat down at the end of last year and we both looked at each other and said, you know, I think we can get better on the swim, the bike and the run. And while I feel that, you know, I'll keep pushing to try and go faster here. But, you know, the bike is definitely the place where I think most time can be made up. Maybe a couple more minutes on the run. I don't know that I'd be running, you know, much under that. But certainly the swim, it depends on the conditions. Always trying to be a better swimmer, hopefully get close to that front pack. But again, I've shown that my formula last year worked, and that, you know, I missed out on the front pack by almost 5 minutes, and then biked pretty solidly, didn't give up too much time on the bike, and then, you know, just was still able to run pretty fast. But yeah, I still feel that the bike is where I can gain the most time, and that's what we're kind of working on. I guess you look at triathlon as a full package, and you're trying to chip away at minutes, seconds, wherever you can, and the bike's where you can make up the most time, so that's where we put our emphasis. Rachel Joyce, I think she's shown that she's the most solid Ironman athlete. She's been racing in Kona since I've been racing here, and she finished lower than sixth once, and that was when she had a terrible chest infection, super sick, and I think she only finished 11th. So she's a rock solid athlete. She gets it right on the big days, so I think she's the biggest threat for the win.
What are you going to do to let loose after the race?
a lot of Mai Tais, lava flows, margaritas, burgers, and pretty much whatever else goes.